Hello students, so in the previous class we were talking about that of the law of conservation of energy. So we studied that how law of conservation of energy, it says that energy can either be created or destroyed. It means the energy which get converted from one form to the other form, one form of energy get converted to the other form of energy. But when you try to find the total amount of energy, total amount of energy remain constant, remain same. So this proves the energy it remain conserved, and this is the basis of the law of conservation of energy. So we will go through that of the how the potential energy get converted into that of the kinetic energy. So in that student we saw that if suppose we make a ball to come throw a ball from that of a height, so at height the potential energy will be maximum, and as it starts coming down to the ground, potential energy starts decreasing because the height of the ball is decreasing and the velocity of the ball is increasing, thus the kinetic energy increases. Okay, so we can say that potential energy keeps on decreasing while the kinetic energy keeps on increasing. So we can say this one also, that the potential energy is now converting into that of the kinetic energy. So here student, there is a fluctuation, there is a variation, there is a loss and the gain of energy occurring that of the potential energy as well as in that of the kinetic energy. But when you try to find the total amount of energy at any of the point, then you will observe that the total amount of energy at any of the point will be equal, will remain the same. Okay, so if the object, if it is falling from height to that of the ground, any position, whether this one, whether this one, whether this one, if you find the total amount of energy, that is total amount of a potential energy plus kinetic energy, then that will remain the same, although the potential energy and kinetic energy keeps on increasing and decreasing. The same thing we can do if suppose we throw a ball in the upward direction. At that time also what will happen students, since we are throwing in the upward direction, so h is increasing, height is increasing, and if height is increasing, potential energy increases, velocity decreases. So we will say that since the velocity decreases, the kinetic energy decreases. Just opposite to this one. Okay, so there also students, if you try to find the total amount of energy at any of the point, you will find that the kinetic energy and that of the potential energy, both when you sum both of them, you will get the same value of the energy at any of the point. Okay, at each of the point, at any of the point, you will get the same value. Okay, so this proves the conservation of energy or law of conservation of energy. Now today we will continue with the same topic student, that is conservation of energy, but this time you will see the conservation of energy in that of the simple pendulum. So swinging of that of the simple pendulum, or we can say that when we see the conservation of energy in a simple pendulum, swinging of the simple pendulum is a very good example to explain the law of conservation of energy. Why is this so student? Because it explains about that of the potential energy, it tells about the kinetic energy, as well as it will explain the mixture of both, that is kinetic energy and potential energy. Okay, so when you see this, then you will see that this is a kind of a simple illustration which explains about the transformation of the potential to kinetic energy, transformation of kinetic to potential energy. Okay, so it is a very good example to explain the transformation of the potential and that of the kinetic energy. Now we will understand how it is so students. So if you see a simple pendulum, a simple pendulum is what student? If Okay, so if this is a bob, a metal bob is there, and a thread or a string is there. Okay, so these are the two things which is present in that of a simple pendulum. Okay, so due to the presence of this string and that of the metal bob stringers, it will make this metal bob free to move. Okay, so it helps it to swing it properly. When we say the swinging pendulum, it means what? This thread helps the metal bob to swing it in any of the direction. Okay, so two things are there. One is the string and other is that of the metal bob. So what happened here, students, if suppose you take the string, you take that of the metal bob, okay, if this is a metal bob, this one is also a metal bob, and here also a metal bob is there. Okay, this is the position A, this is the position B, and this one is position C. Okay, so you have taken that of the simple pendulum and you stretch it, you pull the that of the pendulum to a position B. So at first it will go to this position, that is after B. So when you were pulling it to that of the position B, students, so what you were doing, if suppose this is the simple pendulum, so you are taking it to a high to in the upward direction. So in the upward direction, it means you are taking the taking the metal bob of that of the simple pendulum to a certain height. Okay, so as you increases the height of that of the metal bob, it will gain the energy. You have done some work and that work will get stored in the form of an energy. That energy is the potential energy. So we will say that at position B, student, because it is little bit higher than that of position A, so we can say that this one is having the maximum potential energy, or this bob is having, this at position B, this pendulum, this metal bob is having only that of the potential energy. So here potential energy is maximum, kinetic energy is minimum, or we can say zero. Okay, so as we leave the bob, student, that metal bob, what will happen? It starts coming, it starts moving. Okay, so it starts coming to that of the position A, right? So it starts moving. You have taken the pendulum like this and you just stretch it to a heighted position, to a position B, and then you leave it. Then what will happen? It starts moving to that of position A. Okay, so it comes in motion, and you know that as the object comes in a motion or starts moving, potential energy keeps on decreasing and kinetic energy increasing. Okay, so here what happened, the height decreases, kinetic energy starts increasing. So when you try to find the total amount of energy in any of this position between A to B, that will be equals to the potential energy plus kinetic energy. So we can say here, student, when we are saying that here only potential energy is there and kinetic energy is zero, okay, and here potential plus kinetic energy, it means while coming from that of the B to A, potential energy is decreasing, but the kinetic energy is keeps on increasing. So if you try to find any of the value between the B to A of the amount of energy, you will see that potential as well as the kinetic energy have some value. Although potential energy decreases and kinetic energy increases, but both of them is having some value, students. Then as the bob comes to the position that is at A, okay, this is the position. Okay, so as it comes to this position, that is at position A, it will not need to stop, students. So we will say that at position A, because here the height completely comes to zero from where it has been started, from where it, the work has to be done so that it will reach to a certain height. So here the height will become zero. So potential energy will be zero and kinetic energy will be maximum. So at position A, it is only having the kinetic energy, right? Maximum potential energy is here, only potential energy is there, and here the maximum kinetic energy and potential energy will be zero. So we can say that at position A, only kinetic energy is possessed by that of the metal ball. Now again, what will happen? It will not going to stop soon and it will start moving to that of the position C. So it starts moving to that of the position C. So now you see here again what is going on. This from A, it starts moving to a certain height. So height is increasing, students. So what will happen? Potential energy starts increasing, but kinetic energy keeps on decreasing because it is moving in an upward direction. And you know that as it is moving in an upward direction, the velocity will start decreasing. But since the height is increasing, so potential energy will increase. So here the potential energy will get increased. Now see here, students. Okay. So here potential energy, and as it reaches to position C, now it is moving from A to C. So gradually the potential energy is increasing, and that of the kinetic energy keeps on decreasing. At position C, the metal bob will have the maximum potential energy but minimum kinetic energy. So we will say again that at position C, it will have a potential energy only or maximum potential energy. Okay, so that is potential energy. Again, it will move to that of the position A, student. So as it starts moving to that of the position A, so what is going on? Again, the height keeps on decreasing, velocity keeps on increasing. So kinetic energy increases while that of the potential energy decreases. So in between C and A, if you try to find the total amount of energy, the kinetic and that of the potential energy, both of them is having some value. So we will say that in between these two, kinetic energy plus potential energy will give the total amount of energy. Okay, students, so this is the law of conservation of energy. Now, let me explain you again about it, students. At first, what happened? This simple pendulum, you can see by this that there is a transformation of the potential and kinetic energy continuously just going on. First, the potential energy increases, then kinetic energy increases, then potential energy increases. So, what happened? There is a conversion of potential and kinetic energy is continuously taking place in that of the simple pendulum. What we had done, students, we had taken a simple pendulum in which a metal ball is there and a thread is there or a string is there. We had taken that of the metal ball and we stretched it to a certain height. Okay. So what we had done here, we had applied a work on it. Okay. Due to that work, its height increases. So as the height increases, it reaches to certain position. Let the position is B. Okay, so as it reaches to position B, whose height is more than that of a position A, student, so at this position, the potential energy of that of the metal ball will be maximum. Right? And the kinetic energy, it will be zero. So here at position B, the potential energy is maximum. It means we can say that at position B, metal ball is having only potential energy, no kinetic energy. So either you can write it is having the maximum potential energy at position B and minimum kinetic energy, or you can say that it is having only that of the potential energy. Now, what happens, student? As it reaches here, when you leave the ball, what will happen? It starts coming to that of the position A. So when you leave it, it starts moving. And as it starts moving, student, as it comes in a motion, we can say that the kinetic energy increases and potential energy decreases. So from B to A, potential energy keeps on decreasing, kinetic energy keeps on increasing, and as it comes to position A, the potential energy will become zero and kinetic energy will become maximum, right? And the reason is, students, because at A the height becomes zero, okay, velocity will becomes maximum, so kinetic energy increases maximum while that of the potential energy will be zero. Now if you're not going to stop it just because of the kinetic energy, and again it starts moving to position C. As it starts going to that of the position C, so you see here, student, there is again change in the position, and the change in the position energy is present in it is the potential energy. So at position C, again the ball will have a maximum potential energy and minimum kinetic energy. Then again it will reaches to that of the A, so potential energy decreases, kinetic energy increases, and here at position A the kinetic energy will be maximum. So you see here, once the potential energy is decreasing, it means it is getting converted into kinetic energy. As kinetic energy decreases, it means it is getting converted into that of the potential energy. When you try to find the amount of the total amount of energy at any of the position of the position A or C or B or in between AC or in between AB, anywhere, students, then you will see that although there is a variation in the value of the potential and that of the kinetic energy, but the total amount of energy, it is the sum of the potential and kinetic energy, will remain the same at each point or at any of the point in which the ball is moving or swinging. Okay, so we can say that this is what, there is a conservation of energy, there is no change in that of the energy. Now you see here, students, although the pendulum is continuously moving, this will be, it is continuously swinging, but after some time what you will observe that it will get stopped. Reason is the friction, the air friction which is working on it continuously makes it speed slower, and finally what will happen, the ball will comes to rest position. But till it is swinging, student, the conversion of the kinetic to that of the potential, it will continuously happen. Okay, so this is what, this is the law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy, it explains that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. One form of energy get converted into the other form of energy, and then maybe there can be a loss or the gain of energy occur, but if you find the total amount of energy, then it will remain constant. One thing it should be noted, student, that if a body which does work, it loses energy, and a body on which work is done, that gains energy. Now you can see here, you can write it that a body which, or a body does work, loses energy and a body on which work is done gains energy. Okay, so for example, student, if suppose you kick a football, so what are you doing? You are doing a work on it, so you are losing energy. Okay, and when you kick the football starts moving. It means the body on which you had done work, it gains energy and you do it, starts moving. But the body which does work, it loses. You yourself, you loses your energy, and that energy get transferred to that of the football, and you do it, starts moving. So football on which the work is done, it gains energy, and your body, it loses energy because you does the work. The same thing happen if suppose you take the stone and keep it on a high height. What will happen? When you apply the work on that of the stone, you are losing the energy, but stone is gaining an energy, and that energy is the potential energy. Okay, so you can take any of the examples, student, with the body which does work, it always loses the energy, and the body on which work is done, it always gains the energy. Okay, so this is the law of conservation of energy, that of the simple pendulum, and we have also studied about the conservation of energy, what is it. Okay, now we solve one question which is related to that of the law of conservation of energy student. So senior student, this is the question. Question is that express law of conservation of energy in the form of an equation for a body of mass m is given here, falling from a point A at the height h, B at the height above from the ground, and a C is there. Okay, so don't get confused with the question, I'll explain you. The question is asking that a condition is given here, and with the help of a condition, you have to prove that whether it is expressing itself, whether it is showing that of the law of conservation of energy or not. Here, a body is there which is having a mass m, and it is falling from a point A, right? And from point A, it reaches to that of the C, which is having a height of h, right? Okay, so a body which is kept at height h is made to fall to that of the ground, and in between, two positions are given here, that is B and C. We have to explain that whether it is following the law of conservation of energy or not, students. Okay, so it can be explained very easily. Let me show you how is it so. So you see here, student, law of conservation of energy, it explains that the total energy before transformation and after transformation remains the same. Okay, means that at every point the total amount of energy remains the same, although there is a transformation of energy occurs. Okay, it means the potential energy get converted to kinetic energy, but the total amount of energy when you try to find at each of the point, it remains the same. So this is the only condition by which we can able to understand, able to explain the law of conservation of energy, or whether it is following the law of conservation of energy. Now see here, student, at A position where it was kept at a height. Now we have to find the amount of energy, total amount of energy at position A, when the body is at position B, and when it is at position C. So, at first we will start with at position A. What happened in the at position A, student? The body is at a heighted place. Okay, so since it is at a heighted place, there the potential energy will be maximum. Because we had taken the object to a certain height, so we had applied the work on it, and here the height is maximum, so potential energy will be maximum, thus the kinetic energy will be zero because still it is not moving, so velocity will be zero, so kinetic energy will be zero. Okay, height is more, potential energy is more, velocity is less, so kinetic energy will be less. So here the velocity is zero and height is the maximum. So potential energy will be maximum, student. Now what kind of a work is done? What will be the potential energy here at position A? So potential energy will be equal to mass is given. So mass is m into acceleration due to gravity, and height is given, that is h. Right? So this is the height, student. Acceleration due to gravity by which it is moving, and mass is already given here. We know that to find the value of that of the potential energy, it will always mass into acceleration due to gravity into h, mgh. So here, since the potential energy is maximum, so we will say the potential energy will be equal to mgh, right? Now, what about the kinetic energy, students? So velocity will be zero, so kinetic energy will be zero. Now we have to find the total amount of energy at position A. So total amount of energy will be equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. So that will be equals to mgh plus 0 or mgh. Okay, so at position A, the total amount of energy will be equals to mgh. So we can write it here, that is at position A, what is the total amount of energy student? That is mgh. Okay, now we have to find at position B. See student, we are knowing the height of the object from A to C, but we are not knowing that how much height, how much distance is traveled by the object from A to B. So we will consider that the height will be x. Okay, so if AB is x, so what is the distance, what is the height of BC student? That will be equals to h minus x. Right, total height is h, and if we consider the height of AB is x, so what will be the BC? You can understand it by this. AC is equals to what? This AC will be equals to AB plus BC. Right? So if total height is h students, and we consider that height of A to B is x, why we are finding the height of AB student? It is because we have to find the value of the potential and kinetic energy at position B also, at position C also. Okay, so for that purpose we will consider the height of A to B is x. So x plus BC, this BC, so what will be the BC student? We will keep the BC like that. Okay, now we have to find the value of BC. So when you make this x to move to the left side, then what will happen? H minus x will be there, that will be equal to BC. So I think now you have understood then how we get a value of BC. Okay, so BC is equal to h minus x. So this will be h minus x. Now we are able to find the value at position B. So at position B student, the potential energy is equal to mgh. Okay, and kinetic energy will be equals to, now see a student, one second, before kinetic energy let me tell you. Okay, potential energy we are knowing that is mgh, but you see here student, as it starts coming down, the potential energy starts decreasing, and at B it loses the height from h to x. Okay, because it comes from h, this is the h1, and it comes to b, that is x. Okay, so here height will becomes mg h minus x. Why we are doing it? Because potential energy, it means it just keep losing that of the height. Okay, so up to which position it loses that of the height student? That is x. So we are writing here h minus x. What about the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy, we know that half mv square, and v square will be equals to 2gx. How does it came to this? You can understand it according to third law of equation. V square, u minus u square is equals to 2gh. Why we are using gh students? Because we are carrying the things against the acceleration due to gravity, and height will be represented, that distance will be represented by height. So we are taking it gh either rather than that of the as. So instead of as, 2as, we will use 2gh. So initially the initial velocity, when it was dropped from that particular height student, at that time the value of the initial velocity is 0. So we will write here v square minus 0 is equals to 2g. Now h, how much height is gained by that of the kinetic energy is h, is x. Okay, so this much height is gained by that of the kinetic energy. So it will become, instead of h, we can write it here x. Okay, so v square will be equals to 2gx. So here its value will be half m 2gx. So that will be equals to this m, this 2 and this 2 will cancel each other. It will become mgx. Now when we sum that of the potential energy and kinetic energy together, student, what we will get? That is mg h minus x plus mg x. So if you open it, what you will get? When you open it, students, you will get mg h minus mg x plus mg x. You can see here mg h mg minus mg x. So this minus, this plus will cancel each other, and what we left here, that is mg h. So at position B also, the value of that of the total amount of energy is mg h. Now we will see at position C. So at position C, the potential energy will be zero and kinetic energy will be half mv square. Right, student, because as it comes to that of the C, the height will be zero, so potential energy will be zero. Now kinetic energy here, it will be equals to half m 2gh. How 2gh, students? Now see here, v square minus u square is equals to 2g. Height now it came to C, so how much height it has been covered by the object, that is h. So instead of writing x, we will write here h. So that will be half m g h. Okay. So when we open the bracket, what we will get? We will get half into m into 2 g h. 2 cancel each other, and what we left here, student, again we will get the same value, and that is m g. So you can see here, either the object is placed at A, either the object is placed at B, or it is placed at C, the total amount of energy comes out at mgh. So this proves that it is explaining the law of conservation of energy.